five different high school players. 4 weeks ago, 25 children and assorted parental units started on this, and they've been working their little hearts out. You prepare to tear eggs. One thing that's unique about our play is it's a mashup of a couple of different fairy tales, Brothers Grimm fairy tales, which normally are a little dark, but this is not. This is a comedy. So please remember that this is humor. Please don't be afraid to laugh.
We're in the mood.
It's also a unique production in that as we were putting this together, we couldn't find just one thing to do. And so we had a great script that was written for us, for these specific children. And each child had a voice in the script and also in their character. So that's very unique, just like the robot is unique. So we want to thank the ARC for allowing us to perform this in this space. And all the ticket sales do go to benefit the ARC. So please, give generously, give often. We will have an intermission, and there will be concessions available in the cafe. And the concession sales will help us reimburse the parents and other community members that we so graciously gotten things from. You see, every year we start out as a little home school group. We don't have tuition from a school. We don't have a building. We don't have government funds. We don't have anything. So we fly by the seat of our pants. And we open our arms, and you embrace us. So, please, silence your cell phones. Please refrain from any flash photography. Please keep the aisles clear. If you find a need to exit the theater during the performance, there is a theater door that you came in back there. Okay, don't use that one now. That. And please, while the production is going on, if you could keep your wrappers and crunching to a minimum. Yeah. But please, laugh. So on behalf of the Kickapoo Homeschool Players and here, we hope you enjoy the show.
Not only had the queen forgotten to name the old witch as the child's godmother,
She had forgotten to invite the old witch altogether, and when the old witch found out, she became very angry indeed. Gazing upon the newborn prince, the old witch smiled, a very strange, unsettling smile. She shook her finger, and then... she cast her spell upon the infant.
Solved. I'm your gal. Where's it, Father? Father, you and the cobbler are so obsessed with dancing shoes. Why is that, I wonder? I think that is the real mystery.
Her Royal Highness, Princess Lily!
Oh, Father dear. Dear Father, why did you wake me so early? I was sleeping.
You shouldn't be sleeping at this hour, Lily.
Pray tell then, when should I be sleeping?
Perhaps if you were not all night doing. What is it you are doing all night, Lily?
Oh, really, Father, what do you think I'm doing?
Her Royal Highness, Princess Adelia!
Considering, Father, why do you think I wear these?
Perhaps
Yes, Father, as you wish.
Any man who discovers how my daughter's river shoots out each night shall be given the hand of a princess in marriage.
Father, no! I am not chattel to be bartered away!
And what makes you think the winner will choose you, my bossy firstborn?
Father, how could you? They are just children, not prizes for your silly games. Now you've really made me mad.
Oh, Father, now you've made me cry!
The real mystery is why you think this is a mystery.
You are not following the rule.
Oh, Father, how could you? You said it was a precious jewel to be treasured.
I absolutely will not allow it, Father.
I am the king. I decide what happens, not you, and I have decided. Give my orders. Now spread the proclamation far and wide. Tell the chef to prepare the wedding feast, or soon one of you shall be wed.
I'm warning you, Father. Be reasonable.
You'd best learn to hold your tongue, Magnolia, or you'll find yourself in old spits.
Well, I never was!
Parsley, sage, rosemary, and moss?
Well, yes, but I think a place in the courtyard. Let me set these here and we can go look together. My name is Magnolia. Now I must get my ball back. It's terribly important to me.
The well is no place for a princess, especially an old one. Have you a death wish? Can you even swim?
Well, no. But I must do something.
Well, spite your bossiness. I'm not one to hop away from a princess in need. I'll make you a deal. I'll retrieve this precious golden ball of yours, but I need something in exchange.
From me? What could you possibly need from me? Are you even sure you can retrieve it? You look a little, shall we say, plump around the middle.
Oh, it's the whole thing. It helps me float. It's my blubber.
Blubber? Egads, did you say blubber?
Yes. These frogs are quite proud of our blubber. The lady frogs in particular are quite partial to the blubber.
Well, I see. How about that bar, you froggy? I'll give you anything you want. Jewels, perhaps? Diamonds? Oh, I know. A lovely green emerald to match your lovely, slimy green skin.
Thanks for noticing, but no. A frog has no use for jewels.
A silk gown, maybe. I have plenty of silk gowns. We could make a nest for you out in the forest to rest your sweet little head upon. Perhaps out there somewhere.
Can't deny that when it's tempting, I always dreamed of resting my sweet little head on a silken pillow, but out in the cold, dark forest. All alone? Not so much.
Honestly, Froggy, I think you are just being difficult. Let me make you a nice little nest somewhere far, far from here.
Tell you what I'll consider. But I've been traveling alone for a very long time, and I am awfully lonely. What I really want is a filly.
A filly? Like a horse?
No, not a filly. A filly. How do you say it? A friend. I want you to be my friend, and I want to be your friend.
Your friend? But I don't have time for friends. I'm a very busy princess, and rich in the kingdom. And? Well, I just simply can't be friends with a frog. Besides, what would people say?
They would say, my little princess Magnolia with a
stunningly handsome frog. She is such a fun-loving, carefree princess. See how she laughs and delights at life.
Oh, the ladies, if that would ever happen.
Which part? To be friends with us. Stunningly handsome frog part or the fun-loving, carefree part?
Well, I suppose I could try to be your friend if you bring my ball back, but I have no time for your silly games.
Finally, start to our bargain. But there's
one more thing. But I've already agreed to your request.
I have three wishes. Actually, they always come in threes.
I didn't know that. Always in threes? Well, that explains it. I've been doing it wrong all these years. All right, Froggy, what are your three wishes?
I wish for us to be friends, and I wish for you to invite me to dinner at the palace.
That's two.
Yes, one at a time. Now how hard can it be to invite a little frog to dinner?
Fine, dinner. And what, pray tell, is wish number three?
Oh, that's a real easy one. That's a pillow idea of yours. No, that's a real job. I wish to sleep in your bedchamber on a silken pillow right next to you, so that we can know each other so much better.
In my bedchamber? You can! I can't have a frog, a male frog at that, in my bedchamber with my sisters? Oh no, that would never do.
My lady, I give you my word that my poor manners would be the perfect gentleman. Oh, of course. You're happy leaving your golden ball at the bottom of the well? Then I'll just bid you a fond adieu.
No. All right. I agree to your terms, but please hurry. I'm so worried about my ball.
Congratulations!
Father, this is so unnecessary. Locking us in night after night like caged birds? Hardly a loving way to treat your daughters.
Yes, Father. What would happen if the castle caught fire? We would have no way to escape.
Really? Something tells me you'd find a way.
Really, Father? I'm the sneaky one. Not her. If anyone could find a way out, it would be me.
Yes, Father. I'll make sure they follow the rules.
It is such a lovely night. Look at that beautiful moon. Must we really go to sleep, Father?
Yes, Father.
Can't you sleep a bit longer?
You mean that always makes me a big giddy!
I am, but I don't think we can can stop this them from all together unless we keep them from learning our secrets.
Yes, like I always say, rules are the rules.
Now that is nonsense. I am not going to let some little edict decide if or who I marry. Besides, I doubt there's a man out there who can keep up.
Careful, Azalea.
The girls will have to learn eventually. Might as well be now. When you're old enough, only marry a man who sets your heart on fire. Never settle for less than you deserve. And definitely do not let him boss you around.
Well, I agree on that last part at least. I simply don't want to be told what to do for the rest of my life.
But you need to laugh at me, Magnolia. You really do.
And I prevent it be fun. I don't want to marry them.
But we can have some fun with them. Yeah.
Well, as horrible as marriage sounds, you might have to make the best of it, Magnolia. I mean, after all, rules are the rules.
And you're the oldest, and you know the royal suitors will all want to marry you. So what would you wish for if you could make a wish to the full moon?
Well, if I had to, I would wish for a man who is kind, who loves the birds and the flowers, and who cares for my sisters just as much as I do. And yes, perhaps one who makes me laugh.
That's the spirit, Magnolia.
And one who loves to dance. Don't forget that, Magnolia.
Yes, Poppy, one who loves to dance.
Anything else? Come on, out with it.
Well, a little adventure would be nice, but I'd wish you were tall, dark, and handsome.
Magnolia has a dream wish. Magnolia has a dream wish.
Well, it's all nonsense anyway. We won't be discovered, and we shan't be forced to marry some royal suitor. Of that, I'm quite certain. Now time for sleep.
The royal suitors arrive at dusk.
Magnolia.
Magnolia? Is this true?
Is what true?
A door with a frog? Wait, no, no. A frog and a door for you?
For me?
Yes, for you.
Oh, Father, whatever do you mean? I mean, why would a frog be at the door for me?
If I knew the answer to that, why would I ask you in the first place?
Oh, Father, that is a real mystery.
Did you invite a frog to banquet with us, Magnolia?
Well, now that you mention it, I think I might have perhaps... Yes, I think I did invite a frog to dinner.
Oh!
I didn't think you would actually come.
That is strange. You actually invited a frog to the banquet with us.
You're full of surprises these days, Magnolia.
Well, it seems so. Let me explain.
For dinner. Oh, no mistake, you shall
the thinner.
The peace de resistance.
The peace de resistance.
I will reveal the
think, Your Majesty. That would have been most pleasant for us both. I, Maggie.
Oh, good, of course. You don't know my eldest, Princess Magnolia?
Sit next to her. Make yourself at home.
Yes, unspeakable dangers.
Speak to the unspeakable danger!
Bellissimo! It's Russian. question for old babushka.
Babushka, I say, you say, say what you mean to say, and stop saying what you are saying, because you didn't say anything.
Thank you.
go over there, Froggy. I do not want any warts.
I am not a toad, Your Highness.
He's right, Poppy. It's the toads that have a wart and the short, stumpy legs. Froggy here has long legs and no warts.
And I am soft and moist.
Oh, moist? Did you say moist?
Ew! Come on, ladies, give a frog a chance. I just want to be your friend.
Well, that's reasonable, but you're upsetting my sister. So we'll have to be friends from a distance. Over there, with Magnolia.
Yes, over here, frog. We've made a nice little nest for you.
Ew! Oh, how is about this story? I've always wanted one of those.
Is there anything else I can do for you, Your Highness?
Wind the music box on your way out.
Oh, goody story time.
There will be no stories tonight. You need your rest.
I'm not...
Be a good frog and don't make me go over there.
I'm
I remember the tunnel, following the princesses, and then...
And then nothing, a big, fat nothing.
You too? One moment I think I remember, and then I don't.
No, same here. I always feel a little bit this way, but yes. Always on today. It's like I see my doppelganger, my other self, and then I don't.
I've got bats in my battery and my head is spinning.
Where is that frog? I want to know what he saw. Where is he hiding?
Why is he hiding?
What should we do to make him talk?
Yes, we need to make him sing.
Yes, sing like a bird.
Now, gentlemen, perhaps there's a better way. Think about it a moment. What is it you are actually after?
Yes. Well, perhaps instead of making the frog sing like a bird, make the bird sing.
I think I follow you. We need to know from someone who knows what there is to know about, well, you know.
I think perhaps I follow you on that one.
We need the info. Need to go to the source.
And the source is the words.
How many times do I have to say it?
Ah, yes, the princesses. And so, what do you propose, Babushka?
It seems to me that if you really want to gain confidence of the princesses, that perhaps you should try the old-fashioned way.
Old-fashioned? Yes, that would be good. But what is this old-fashioned way?
Ah, that's definitely my department. Romance. Passion, excitement. Amore. That is what the ladies are after.
Now that's the spirit. You should turn on the charm and endear yourself to them. Make them laugh. That way you can gain their confidence. Who could resist a charming prince?
That's it. Turn on the charm.
Charm? I do not think I have much of what you call charm.
Of course you do. Every man has that extra special something he calls upon when trying to win the affection of a lady love. Perhaps a song? A dance? Something? That will set you apart from the others.
Unruly! I have just the same!
What is it?
Oh no! This is my special secret!
Yeah. I get it now. Those birds are in for a trick!
Well, for me, it comes natural. I open his mouth and the voice of angels speak it through me. No woman can resist.
No. No one can charm the ladies like a Spaniard.
So, how do I find this so-called charm?
You need to dig a deep. The dark recesses of your soul. You will find it a day. The prince of Zurich. Love it!
I think I've got it now.
Thank you.
and put them there every night. Would you mind accompanying me?
Well, I don't really sing.
No, but... I've written this little ditty for the birds, and it is a song about the birds. And Princess Poppy here has agreed to assist me with a bird interpretive nut.
Thank you.
A flamingo is a frilly pink bird.
Like you, my little flamingo?
Very funny. Not flamingo, flamenco.
Flamingo, flamenco, potato, potato,
what is it, princess?
Oh, it was just so beautiful. I have no words for it. No words at all.
Well, in my country, when we have no words, we speak from the heart, the ear.
But that's the heart.
Oh, but it is. And when you speak from this heart, you open your mouth like it is. And then you take in that passion, that the feeling, the pain, the pleasure, the beauty, the horror, and you release it. Come, release it. Come, sing to me, my angel of music, Christine!
But I'm really not Christine!
Just go with it, Christine!
No!
Indeed. Perhaps she's under match.
Yes, I think maybe so.
I wonder if we can get that.
but you. You are the fuel that feeds the fire, the one that keeps them warm.
I try to keep things lively, keep them all guessing. Can you handle that?
I live for it. I'd say it, but it is hard for this Russian to keep up. I never met the woman so fierce.
Yes.
Father, dear father, my sisters and I want what all women want, sovereignty, the right to choose for ourselves the life we wish to lead, each according to our own heart's desires.
I think I'm beginning to see what's been in front of me all along. A promise is a promise.
Quite right, Cobbler, quite right.
You've taught me much, Frog, Royal Suitors, and for that I thank you. My daughter, will you ever forgive me? I was blinded by grief and lost my way. I love you all so dearly.
Yes, Father, we love you.
But a promise is a promise, and I cannot back out. Which of my daughters will you take from me, Frog?
Well, I would pick the one that shines the brightest. To be your eldest, Princess Magnolia. She has a heart that knows no measure, and she has cared for all your daughters, protected them, tended to them, and loved them, sacrificing her own happiness for theirs, and I have grown to love her dearly.
And she is yours, Rob?
No, no, she is not mine. She is not a prize to be given away. She has a mind and a heart of her own. I could never force the woman I love to do something against her own will, and neither should you, Your Majesty.
And is there nothing you would ask of us in reward for your services here?
My fair princess, no, it is too much for me to ask for you to love me in return. But if you would consider bestowing upon me just one kiss, I would be happy forevermore.
My little friend, you too have grown dear to me. And in the spirit of friendship and all you have done for us, I graciously bestow upon you this kiss.
Dance.
Dance? Did you say?